In Aaron of Mercy, we met the Organians, who forced the Federation and the Klingon Empire to cease hostilities. They formed an uneasy peace, and in this next episode, it's been about 3 years since the treaty has been in force, and each side is still mistrustful of the other. Old hatreds die hard. It parallels the tension between the United States and the Soviet Union in the late 1960s. There were those in power who would have escalated the conflict in Southeast Asia, and there were others who would have ceased fighting altogether. The factions were known respectively as the Hawks and the Doves. This episode gives away its underlying sympathies with its title, The Day of the Dove. Michael Ansara, who stars as the Klingon Captain Kang, was a well-known face to television viewers in the 60s. He specialized in playing exotic heroes and villains in The Outer Limits, Voyage to the Bottom of the Sea, Time Tunnel, and Land of the Giants, among others. And speaking of Klingons, The Day of the Dove is the only episode of the original series to feature a female Klingon. Wardrobe designer Bill Tice did a wonderful job of feminizing the typical Klingon uniform, and the makeup job for actress Susan Howard gave her character Mara an element of realism. And so another creature that feeds on negativity gets its just rewards. Remember Red Jack in Wolf in the Fold, that murderous entity fed on fear? In the Day of the Dove, it was hatred that both defined and nourished the creature. It's interesting to note the creature's innate ability to create false memory. Only in recent court cases have psychiatric experts validated such a concept. Like the theory of parallel universes, this was yet another instance where our fiction became an odd reflection of some small part of the real world.